guys, welcome back to Auto Repair guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel guys. In today's video we will show you guys how to remove and replace front brake pads and front disc rollers on Ford Edge guys, first generation. That should cover guys the first generation from 2007 to 2014, even the one with the facelift guys. So stay with us guys, we will show you how to do that. In the meantime we will have more than 200 videos on this car. Why? Because our mission guys is to save you as much money as we can. So let's go ahead and start on the process now. So we have the car guys already. Okay, you can see on jack, lifted in the air. You have to use jack stand, always do that. And we will have the front right tire in the air guys. Now we'll demonstrate on the front right, the front left will be the same way. So let's start on the process now. Okay, so we're just removing the tire now. Perfect. Okay guys, and that's what we have here now. So we'll turn the steering wheel to the right because we're working on the right side. That way we can get to the brake bolts and all that. Every time guys you put new brake pads, I would recommend either to replace your rollers. But if they're pretty thick like ours are, what you have to do, okay, it's recommended to take them to the machine shop and they cut the top layer. Stay with us and we'll show you what we're talking about. They cut and resurface the rollers, and that way guys that disc will be like brand new again. It will be nice, smooth and even, and the new pads will be seated really good. So we're using guys that Interphone spray. It's really good penetrating spray, and we're going to spray, okay, between the roller and the hub, so that way it can come off way easier later. So we need guys a 17 millimeter socket now, and we're going to remove two bolts that hold that brake caliper to the mount. Okay, this one is really tight. Have to be careful not to break your bleeder valve there. So we'll get a little bit bigger tools because obviously this one hasn't been removed for a while. We have the torque specs and all that on the channel guys. Okay, whoever installed those, that's just ridiculous tight guys. It shouldn't be that way. Okay, perfect. Okay, came loose now finally. One bolt with the glide. Okay, you can see what it looks like. We're going to put them on the napkin. Removing the second one now. Hold your caliper with one hand. Okay, this is the second bolt. Okay, one is shorter than the other one. Check this thing out. The top one is longer bolt. Now, you need to grab your caliper, guys. Need to get some wire or a heavy duty, super heavy duty zip tie. We're going to tie it to the strut there, and then we'll tie the caliper so that way it's not hanging on the brake line, because if it's hanging on the brake line you're going to there is a chance to cause damage to it and lose your brakes later. So you have to be extremely careful guys. So those are guys the brake pads. Okay, got them out. And this is the other one, right there. So, now, what else we need to do? So now guys, you cannot just remove the disc roller like that. You have to remove that bracket, the caliper bracket, that way you can slide the roller out. Otherwise you're going to hit and you cannot pull it out. Okay, 19 millimeter socket, and we have two bolts that we need to get loose. Okay, perfect, getting those loose now. Okay. Okay, we're going to get the caliper bracket here. Pull it out. Now that we sprayed the roller, it even came out super easy, guys. It's not stuck. And just gently pull it out. So you can see, guys, this is the roller now. We're going to take it to the parts store so they can resurface it and we can install the pads. Because you can see, okay, you're going to have smoke canals, you're going to have some deformation, rust. You can see low and high spots that could cause brake pulsation and steering wheel vibration. So we'll take it to them, have it resurfaced, and we'll show you guys what it will look like. So guys, we just received the disc roller from the parts store next door. They resurfaced it, guys. They cut the top layer. You can see they make it nice and even. The guy said that we had a little bit of rough spots, and you can see how great looking it is. So this is, guys, ready to go. You either replace the roller or you resurface it like that. That's the recommended thing to do. So now, guys, we'll be using the brake caliper compressor tool. This is for a single piston, guys, but we'll show you guys how it works. Okay, now we're going to use a brake parts cleaner here, guys, and we're going to clean the rubber seals to make sure that there is no dust and stuff like that, because what will happen now when we compress it, guys, those pistons will go inside, and you want to make sure that these rubber seals are actually, guys, okay, clean and not contaminated with dust, because later that dust, okay, can develop, guys, leaks, okay, and sticking pistons and all that stuff. So we'll be using the old, okay, old brake pad here, guys. This is the two set that we'll be using. Old brake pad, we'll place it like that. Okay, we'll show in a second. Now, we're going to get one of the compressors. Okay, this is for a single caliper too, but it will work in our case as well. And we'll use, okay, that plate here now as well. We'll show you in a second. Okay, like that. We'll go ahead. Screw it like that until it starts compressing. And now you're going to notice, guys, how when we turn, it's going to compress both pistons. So it's a little bit harder because we're compressing two pistons, but it's working, you can see. Okay, this is it, perfect. You have to stay until the end because there is a trick that we'll be using now. Otherwise, guys, you may crash your car the first time you start it after you put new brakes. So the set part, guys, they didn't have our brake pads, they ordered the wrong one. So what I'll do, I'll order them online. I found them, check out in the description of the video below. Some come with new shims, some don't. I'll recommend to replace those metal shims as well, those guides there. Otherwise, clean them with brake cleaner, really good, to make sure they're not contaminated. But it's advisable, guys, to replace those every time you replace brake pads. What we do here now, guys, we have some brake pads from a parts car, okay, right here at the shop. So we'll put those until we get the other ones. But practically, whether you're putting the new ones or almost brand new ones, pretty much, okay, the procedure is the same, guys. But definitely, guys, put new pads every time. So now, okay, we're going to go ahead and install the mount here. We're going to get the bolts tight. I'm going to share the torque specs with you in just a minute, guys, so make sure you stay with us, guys, so I can tell you what they are. So we start this one by hand, and then this one on the bottom as well here. Okay, this one started too. So we'll keep going like that until we get them tied by hand, and I'm going to go ahead, get the torque wrench, the big torque wrench, and show you guys, okay, what we need to do. We'll just get them tied by hand now until they stop going. And let's find out about the torque specs now. Now, about the torque specs, guys, you need to check your service manual because your ear model and configuration might differ depending what brakes you have. If you have all-wheel drive, front-wheel drive, all that could differ, but we'll show you what they are for ours. So this is the torque range, guys. Okay, according to the manual now, ours, it says that it needs to be 98 foot-pound or 133 newton-meters. So, 98, okay, foot-pound or 133 newton-meters for ours. Yours always double-check because it doesn't mean that it's the correct one. So, this is a click type wrench. Once we reach that torque, guys, you're going to hear the wrench click and you need to stop immediately. Your handle will move a little bit. Listen now. Okay, we need to go the other way. We're getting it loose that way. Okay, so let me come on this side now. That's it, guys. You don't want to go more. Perfect. That's all we need to do there. So we need to get some brake grease now, guys. You need to apply a very thin amount, pretty much like wipe your finger, but use gloves. Don't ask why we don't, guys. You definitely should use gloves every time. Okay, and you want to apply a little bit on the side of the brake pad, just very, very thin amount. And on the back side, okay, where the pistons will be contacting and the caliper as well. Very thin amount. If you have a big blob of grease, you will attract dust, gravel, and you will not be good for your brakes, guys. Perfect, just like that. So we can go ahead, install this pad now here, guys. Okay, need to make sure it's going in the canals. Perfect, just like that. Now we're going to install the front one. And pushing. Okay, great. So what do we need to do next? We need to get our caliper, remove the wire, okay, that we have here. Don't forget to remove it from the strut later as well, guys. Make sure that the hose is not twisted. Install it like that. Okay, we need to push the seals in. Gotta make sure that the slides are clean. This is the guide pin bolts. Okay, you need to make sure you clean those, guys. Okay, wipe them really good and re-grease them, but very thin. Okay, that's it. That's enough. Very thin amount. The long one goes on top, usually. Okay, unless you have different brakes. Okay, so we cannot show a little bit. We need to readjust. And the bottom one is a little bit shorter. So we'll install this one as well. Okay, start them by hand. Okay, and we'll get them tight to the point that they start getting tight, and I'm going to share the torque specs with you again, guys, so you know what to expect. Now you have to stand till the end because there is something very important that we need to do. Something you shouldn't forget, otherwise your brakes will not work the first few times you pump the brakes. Why? Because right now you can press the pistons in the caliper, so you can install the new pads that are wider. Okay, which means that you have to make room, right? But you will still have more room between the piston and the brake pad. And the first few times that you hit the brake pedal, you will not have brakes because that play will be replaced by braking fluid. So once you're done and get everything tight, before you put the tire on, go inside and pump your brakes. If you're working on the front right side or front left only, if you have one side removed, when you're ready, guys, okay, just pump the brakes about 20 times until the brake pedal feels good and make sure that the brakes are contacting. So we're getting the smaller wrench. It's more convenient, this one, guys, and we get it to 88 newton meters or 65 foot pound. 88 newton meters or 65 foot pound, guys. Again, this is for our specs, guys, for our vehicle, which is a 2007 OO. This one, actually, it's a front wheel drive, excuse me. Okay, we have ours. Okay, this one is ready at 65 foot pound. So we're going to go again until we hear the click. And you have to stop immediately once you hear that click, guys. Listen now. Perfect. Just one more. Okay, right here. Okay, that's it. So now we need to go ahead, pump the brake pedal, and you're going to notice how we're going to compress the brakes. So we put guys everything together now. What's going to happen now, guys? Okay, remember how we compressed the pistons? Okay, now you still have some play between the brake pad and the pistons, okay, both caliper pistons. Now what you need to do, I recommend to go inside the car, pump the brake pedal at least 20 times, because the first few times you press the brake pedal, that play will be replaced by brake fluid, and you want to do that until the brakes contact firmly and your brake pedal feels good. I recommend even when you start your car and everything's together while it's in park with the emergency brake on, brake the pedal until it feels good before putting it in drive or reverse. That way you can avoid guys crashing it or killing somebody. So we're inside now, guys. We have a person inside pumping the brake pedal. Okay, I can definitely see a little bit of movement and we don't have any more play. Okay, and we keep pumping the brake pedal, guys. Pump it at least 20 times to make sure it feels good. So this is it, guys. That's how you remove and replace brake pads, front brake pads and rotors on Ford Edge, guys. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel for more videos and see you guys next time.